Hello everyone and welcome back to the show. There's this mistake that I see a lot of, you know, young professionals, you know, staff members, they do this mistake often. And I was wondering if you're making the same mistake in your work, in your job, in your career, and the things you spend your time doing. On this video, let's break it down and see what we ought to be doing. Hello friend, this is the voice of Ademola Morebise. Hello friend, I believe that one of the greatest mistakes anybody can make is to do the least amount of work that is required in order to get paid. Yet it would amaze you that that is more or less what most of us do, right? We just do the minimum effort required so that we can get paid and move on with our life. Everybody move on with your life and things like that. I think it's a missed opportunity, okay? And I'm going to explain that to you shortly. You see, when you do exactly what you are paid to do, right, it doesn't give you much bargaining power in the long run. When you are paid, right, and all you bring to the job is exactly what they ask you to do, it shows that you are exhibiting zero initiative, right? And so I can assure you that in the near future, maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, maybe not in 2 weeks' time, but eventually I can assure you that we're going to find someone that will charge us less than you currently earn, and we'll be happy to give the person your job. Or better still, we can automate that thing you are doing, and then, you know, we just buy one robot that will keep doing it, isn't it? I mean, you can't conclude that your job is automation proof, that a robot can't do your job at all. I mean, if I can explain your job and say this is step one, step two, step three, step four, I can assure you that we can get a robot to do that job, and the robot probably do a better job, right? And you know, robots don't fall sick, they don't have to attend a burial at the weekend, they don't have family functions, they only exist to do the job we've asked them to do. So you have to think about your job and think about how much initiative you are adding to your job. You can't just, you know, turn up at work, maybe as a freelancer, and all your project, everything you do is just, you know, I mean, doing exactly like this is what you do and that's exactly what you do. You don't bring initiative to the job, you're not taking ownership, you know, that is a missed opportunity. You want to put yourself in a position whereby when they start to debate and say, you know what, we need to cut costs, and they start to make a list of those that, you know, who go under the chopping block. You want it to be that if your name ever come up in such a conversation, right, the amount of value you deliver to the organization will be so obvious, so apparent, right, that in fact, not only do you survive such a the layoffs, right, but you're in a position that in fact you could even walk up to the boss and say, boss, is it not time we start discussing a race? I mean, think about the audacity, right? I mean, they're laying off your colleagues, laying off staff members, and you have enough equity, you have enough bargaining power to go there and say, guys, it has come to my notice that I'm doing the job of 2-3 people, you know, I mean, I wanna see them, you know. And honestly, that is what needs to happen. A lot of times we feel we are saving ourselves for a future, we are saving ourselves for our own things. Don't let me give them my ideas, so that, you know, if I give them my idea and they steal my idea, and what will I have to work with in when I start my own business and things like that. That is myopic thinking, that short-term thinking. What we know about creativity is that the more you use your creativity, the more you get. Like, the more you express your creative ideas, the better you get at this game. And, you know, and really that is why a lot of times when people now start their own thing, they feel they want to put in their best efforts, but then they don't succeed. At the end of the day, they fail because they failed to practice, right? They failed to drive project with full initiative and having stake at the table. They feel, you know, this is not my thing, I'm just being paid to do this thing, I just do this thing and I give, and that's all. When you do that, you're not bringing extra value to the table, so in the short term, it doesn't pay you actually. It doesn't pay you to do that in the short term. And in the long term as well, that you're not doing yourself any good, because now, what you've not done for another person, to be hard for you to actually get into the right frame of mind to do it for yourself, okay? So I want you to understand this thing. It's a big mistake that a lot of people do. They just do the lowest, like what is the minimum amount of work I can do so that I can get paid. If you keep doing that, I'm so sure you are going to lose that job soon, okay? And if you don't lose that job to a human being, you lose to a robot, okay? And even in the long run, by the time you start out on your own, you realize that all those years whereby you didn't put in much effort into what you are doing, all those years you didn't take the initiative, all those years you didn't put in extra effort into the thing you do, all those things will catch up with you in the future, and it will be very, very hard for you to do any better when you are on your own. Why don't you repeat after me this morning? Say, God daily loads me with benefits. I am bold and strong. Every day, in every way, I am getting better and better. My name is Ademola Morebise. Thank you so much for taking our time to check out this video. Remember, you can lead a formidable life. Have a great day. Bye.